Hello. Today, we're going to run through and show you how to remove and install a new universal joint to your PTO system. The universal joint, or UJ for short, is what connects the two yokes of your PTO together. We're going to run through what we think is the easiest way to change a UJ. Let's get into it. Firstly, we need a vise so that it holds have the yoke in place. And spray this some WD-40. We then grab our circlip pliers to remove the circlips. Just giving it a wiggle so that you can get both clips out at the same time. Now, let's go to the other side. And they come out as easy as that. Next up, we secure our PTO system in place. We then grab our hammer and we need to knock between the UJ and the center part of the yoke. Now you can see the cup of the UJ exposed. We flip it over and do the same thing on the other side. Now we've punched out the caps, you can take them off and then remove the first yoke. Repeat the process for the other yoke, releasing the caps, which then exposes your UJ from your yoke. Next up, we need to measure for a new UJ. To do this, we recommend getting a digital vernier so you can be really precise with these measurements. The first measurement that we need to get is the width of our cap. We can see that our cap is 27mm wide. We then need to grab the width from cap to cap, and that is 77mm wide. If you don't have your UJ to hand, you can also take a measurement from the yoke itself. So first up, we need to get a measurement of the width of the hole. We need to get the full width of the yoke from the grooves that are within the yoke. Measure from them to get the width of the UJ. Once you've found your measurements, either from your yoke or your old UJ, you can head over to our website, and if you look on the filter bar on the left-hand side at the universal joint dimensions, you'll be able to filter to find the correct UJ for your PTO setup. So now we've got the correct UJ from our website and we've ordered it, we can now start fitting it to the yokes. Inside the packet, we have the UJ itself, the circlips, and a grease nipple to go on the UJ. When we fit our grease nipple, one thing to consider is if we have it on this end, then we're gonna have the PTO shaft and the PTO guard here. So we're not gonna be able to grease up our UJ. So what we need to do is make sure that our grease nipple is facing towards the end, which joins onto the tractor, so that then we can easily grease up the UJs. Let's get into it. I like to grab the UJ and just twist the end caps to make sure that all of the pins are fully greased. We need to carefully take off these end caps, making sure that none of the pins fall out. There's one, there's two. Making a conscious effort of where our grease nipple is. We then insert that. And then what we need to do is if we push our UJ to the end, we then gently place the cap on. And using our vise, we need to squeeze this so it's flush with the yoke. There we go. Now we've got our cap flush with our yoke. Little trick is getting a nut, placing this on the end of the cap and then tightening up your vise so this secures the cap of the UJ. This is so that then it pushes it onto the other side of the yoke. You always know whether it's enough or not because you should see where the circlips sit. That's what you're looking to expose. Now we do the exact same on the other side. Sometimes these are a little bit stiff when you first push them in. So what I tend to like doing, just getting a hammer and giving them a little tap. and that then frees the bearings up. And then lastly, what we need to do, grab two of our circlips and fit these in place. So with the circlip, we have a sharp edge and a round edge from where they've been punched out. And what we need to do is make sure that the sharp edge is on the outside. Can be a little bit fiddly to get into the groove, but there we go. And we flip our yoke over and do the same on the other side. So next, we do the same for the other yoke. Make sure our grease nipple is pointing outwards so that when it comes to greasing, we make it easier for ourselves. And squeeze it. And then we get our trusty nut again. Final side. We can now insert both our circlips and put that in. And that is our new UJ fitted to our PTO system. If you have any questions about what we've spoke about today, drop a comment down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.